Its mandate is clear. The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office shall be the principal government agency for raising and providing for funds for health programs, medical assistance and services, and charities of national character. It has the authority to hold and conduct charity sweepstakes races and lotteries, engage in health and welfare-related investments and projects, and undertake any other activity that will enhance its funds generation operations. Of its lottery proceeds, 55% shall be set aside as a prize fund, 30% for contributions to the charity fund, while 15% shall be set aside for the operating expenses and capital expenditures of the PCSO.
Simple lang yung tanong ko, bakit ganun na napakalaki nung inyong intelligence fund?
Dahil nga po iro-roll out namin ng nationwide ang STL.
Ano ang pangangailangan for intelligence fund in order to roll out the STL? Alam mo, habang nagsasalita ka rito, bumabaon ka.
Now, the PCSO is being rocked by a fund controversy. From the previous administration, the charity agency gave out funds to donate sports utility vehicles to 7 Catholic bishops and requested for millions of pesos in intelligence funds from then-President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo.
Hindi ko po alam yung technical term na binabanggit ninyo.
Okay. Kayong project officer, dapat alam po ninyo lahat yun. Binobolan nyo kami. Hindi totoo yung sinasabi ninyo. Wala pong intelligence project.
Former PCSO officials, however, denounced the Senate for its alleged bias in probing the fund anomaly. They add current PCSO officials, including Chairman Margie Huico, are not clean themselves and are only after former President Arroyo.
Definitely malicious, and that's tampering public documents. Sila nag-prepare nung audit report ng 2009.
What will come out of this controversy? Will the investigation yield concrete recommendations on how to prevent alleged widespread corruption at the PCSO? And will the PCSO now be true to its mandate to help the poor?
Yet another controversy has been exposed by the Aquino administration. The PCSO, the country's charity arm, finds itself embroiled in an alleged intelligence fund anomaly, a controversial donation to Catholic bishops, and the inequitable distribution of ambulances. How will former PCSO officials tackle this issue, and how will the current PCSO ensure that its funds indeed go to charity? Our question, what should the PCSO do to make its donations transparent? With us, Attorney Joy Rojas, General Manager of the PCSO. Thank you very much, Attorney. We're also joined by Attorney Ed Araullo. Thank you very much. You are the Board Secretary?
Yes.
Okay, and we have PCSO Director Mabel Mamba. And later in the program, we will be joined by Manoling, former PCSO Chairman, and Attorney Raul Lambino. He is the lawyer for former PCSO officials. I know it's been a very busy past 2 weeks for you, or even a month now, preparing to appear in the Senate. But in this first portion of our program, I wanted to look at the powers and functions of the Board of Directors. We are still looking at the same Republic Act 1169.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's correct.
That is what covers your operations. This was enacted in 1954.
That's correct, Tina.
Yes. And what has been changed or amended as far as this Republic Act 1159 is concerned, Attorney?
Nothing much has been amended, Tina. It's practically the same. That's why there are moves in Congress and in the Senate to probably take a look into the charter once again, revisit it, and make the necessary changes in so that it'll be in tune with the times.
Okay, that means you still have sweepstakes, do you?
Yes, we do.
And you still have the horse races?
Yes, we do.
In connection with the sweepstakes?
Yes, we do.
Okay, so that's still part of the PCSO, and then you have the lotto.
And then we have the lottery.
You have the lottery.
Yes.
Okay, so that is very clear. Did you, as a newly installed board on July 1, institute immediate changes as a result of maybe your management style or what you thought was needed to correct some things that you... Margie was a part of the previous board, was she not?
Our chairwoman did, she was the first one who got appointed.
Mm-mm.
And she was ahead of us for the maybe like around less than a month, mm-hmm. she started reviewing the past policies mm-hmm. and board resolutions. So by the time we came in around third week of July, she was already making some recommendations to the board as to the steps and policies that the new board should take.
Ah, okay. Attorney Ed, when you assumed being the board secretary, was there a formal turnover of the previous board that ended June 30, 2010, to this new board?
When you say formal, there was no formal turnover. We just took over the office.
There was no requirement for the old PCSO board to submit. I see it in your rules that they must submit by July a report of what they did to the Office of the President and to Congress.
There was none.
There was no compliance on the part of the previous board.
In fact, that was being asked from us by Congress, by the Senate. And in fact, if I'm not mistaken, the previous board has not submitted any report to the OP and to the two houses of Congress. So the new board right now will be submitting by the end of the month its first annual report when we came in.
What audit report from COA did you as a new board receive? And what years did it cover of the previous board?
It covered 2007 and 2008.
2007 and
no, 2008.
2008.
Last week.
Yes.
2007.
When we first came in.
2008.
Yes.
No, 2008, I think recent. They gave it last, this June.
Yes.
Okay. And the basis of the reports about the intelligence funds, the supposed high-end vehicles, and questionable allocation among people requesting mainly government officials, that was based on which audited report?
That was a COA report, and actually, Tina, it all stemmed from the COA report, which could be downloaded from the website.
Yes. And this was what year of the COA report that was submitted that became the basis?
2009.
Okay.
It was only very recent, mm-hmm. Tina.
So you saw the the high-end vehicles that were supposedly requested by some bishops, which were given to the bishop, containing in the 2009 report?
Actually, in the 2009 COA report regarding the SUVs, there were two issues. That it was taken out from our charity fund, mm-hmm. so there was a misuse of the charity fund for the procurement of vehicles, and secondly, the constitutional prohibition between church and state.
Ah, there is that.
That was stated in the COA report.
Ah, okay.
So COA is asking now, it's an adverse opinion for management's comments regarding those two issues.
Okay. You sit in the board, yes. Mabel. Yes, is this your first time to sit in the board?
Yeah, of PCSO, yes.
PCSO, mm-hmm. How did you come to get a position in the board?
I used to be a member also, well, I used to work also for government. I used to be chairman of the National Youth Commission. Mm. And I was also once the national president of the Philippine JCs. So I guess because of my experience as a youth leader and working with civil society, probably that was one of the reasons that I was chosen to be a member of the board of directors of PCSO.
Okay. When you got into the board of directors of PCSO, do all of you get to discuss about compensation? How did you deal with the issue of compensation? Did all of you as board of directors of PCSO inherit the compensation package of the previous board?
I'm not part of the board, but we inherited whatever there was from the previous management, including the package, the compensation, but in benefits. But like in the case of the new board, they have not really availed of the other packages, mm-hmm. like the car plan, mm-hmm. The new board hasn't availed of any of that, the housing. And the other benefits.
And we even studied which benefits have to be taxed. So instead of adding benefits to the package, we are now even paying more taxes.
So how did you actually explain the compensation package of the people who were brought in because of the Aquino administration?
That's standard.
Standard. So, standard. They are given an appointment paper, and and the benefits are provided.
Salary grade 25, salary grade 24.
Okay.
In a standard.
And as a board of director, do you get a salary?
There's a basic salary.
Of how much?
Oh, very low. People might pity us if we tell you.
20.
No, it's for the board, it's just
20,000 a month.
Yes, yes.
And how many times do you need to attend a meeting? You don't report every day.
We don't report every day, but the chairman requires us to be there more than once a week.
Okay.
So we have board meetings once a week, and then another day is reserved for presentations.
Mm-hmm.
But on other days, we have meetings, or we have to attend to other functions.
You are an active board member, board of director.
Yes,
it's not
working.
An advisory and a policy making, and you get a special fee just to attend the meeting.
It's a working like board.
It's a working board. Mm-hmm. So how much, if you don't mind, how much does a corporate secretary get? How much does he earn, and how much does the chairman
My
of PCSO?
My basic is 36.
36,000?
Yeah.
Gross.
Gross?
Yeah.
With no perks?
Well, may mga housing. I don't know, housing. Rata?
Yeah, rata, yeah.
Rice, subsidy.
Yeah, there's rice allowance.
How much does a general manager get?
51,000 a month.
Yes.
I also get a rata.
Yes.
Rice allowance, and some other benefits.
Yes.
And taxes are withheld, and I'm part of the regular plantilla.
Ah, okay. And how much does the chairman get?
The chairman gets 40,000, double of that of the directors.
40,000. That is what is stipulated now under this present administration.
Yes.
Did the previous board get the same kind of compensation package?
Yes.
That all of you
got? It's the same, yes.
There is no one that gets a special kind of a compensation?
No.
No.
Okay. So one of the things that I noticed here is to promulgate rules and regulations for the operation of the office and to do such act or acts as may be necessary for the attainment of its purposes and objectives. Have you done any of these things to attain your present vision and the way you want to conduct PCSO under the leadership of Margie and under the Aquino administration? Did you have to look seriously in what you needed to do if there were some things that you wanted to change from the previous?
Oh, the present board right now, especially the chairwoman and the four directors, are very busy with their policy making.
Yeah.
They've already amended and revised so many policies from that of the previous board.
Mm.
And they have already made up so many plans and programs, which I, as the general manager, is implementing.
Okay. Under your present way of doing things, the story of the high-end vehicles that were given to the bishop, supposedly, some of them had asked for it, that at the onset was seen by this board as something that was not supposed to have been done. If all of you were sitting in the board of PCSO then, you would to this day not be giving any bishop or anyone that does not comply with your rules.
Well, you see,
money to purchase a vehicle.
Yes, you see, Tina, our board is, most of us are lawyers. So as lawyers, we are kind of careful with the charter and with our mandate.
Mm-hmm.
Our mandate necessarily states it's really for medical and health assistance.
Mm-hmm.
I would assume that if we gave out ambulances to the requesting parties, it should not be a problem because ambulances really carry sick people from one place to another, from remote areas to the nearest rural health center or regional hospitals. It's really a very helpful mechanism of saving lives. With regards to the purchase of vehicles, I think that is not within our mandate also, especially if it's not really for health or medical assistance.
You gave the money, the PCSO then gave the money to the bishops and they bought the vehicle, but it was supposed to have been for an ambulance?
No, they requested for a vehicle and the previous board gave them
the vehicle.
The money to purchase the vehicles.
And they, in their request, identified what kind of vehicle they were buying?
For some of them.
Yes. So tell us in detail.
There was a request for SUVs.
For SUVs, which they could have converted into an ambulance?
No, I don't think they converted it.
Which could have been converted to an ambulance if you used an SUV and you stripped down the chair and...
I mean, why will they do that? We have the ambulance. Mm-hmm. We could have given it to them.
Okay.
At that time, when we took over, there were 230 ambulances to be given out.
Mm-hmm. So did these bishops in their districts already had ambulances in the district that was solicited by the LGU?
I
see your procedures here for getting ambulances, and it's quite simple, but a lot of paperwork.
Yes.
A lot of documents.
Did these bishops who had the SUVs already, did you check if their areas already had ambulances?
Actually, it wasn't us who approved it. It was the previous board. So I'm not sure if they did the checking of those areas, if they already had ambulances. But let me point this out, Tina, that it's not also the fault of the requesting party.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
We get a lot of requests, Director Mamba, the other directors, we get letters for sponsorship, and it's incumbent upon us to see if the request is valid. Valid in the sense that if our mandate would permit us to give such a request. If it's for health and medical related assistance or calamities of national character, by all means, it's in our charter, then we're out there to help these requests. But otherwise, it's kind of questionable. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what the COA report mentioned.
Okay, the other area of discussion at the Senate hearing was the supposed use of the Intel funds for blood money. Is the blood money covered by this special law to contribute funds for the PCSO is mandated to contribute funds for the following government entities? Does this form part of your mandate?
I don't think
Philippine so. Sports Commission?
No. Those are covered by Republic Acts.
The
special
Republic
laws.
Act.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
Laws.
Commission on Higher Education, mm-hmm. Comprehensive and Integrated Shelter and Urban Development Financing Program, the Philippine Centennial Commission, the National Commission on Indigenous People, the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration, the Department of Foreign Affairs, and the Quirino Memorial Center. You are aware of this? Or this is
We
this
are
is
mandated
something?
By law, by those Republic Acts, to make a yearly contribution or a one-time contribution, as the case may be, depending on the EO or the RA, to make contributions to these different agencies. In fact, when the Senate saw this, they also said that it might be time that we should not be giving these contributions to these agencies, because it's like they already are giving based on their on the GAA, and we are still giving an additional funds for these agencies.
So as lawyers, the money that was used by the DFA as blood money, which was paid in check to the victims' beneficiaries, is part of the PCSO mandate?
No,
it's not.
Why not?
Remember, the Intel fund was a special request from the then GM to the president, GMA.
And I believe the letter stated the purpose for which it was supposed to be used for. One, two, three, four. It did not specify blood money.
But it was supposed to be an intelligent fund that was couched in secrecy and confidential.
But you have to state in the letter request what it's going to be used for in general terms.
The main sum, but the itemized utilization was maybe covered in a liquidation report?
I'm not really sure. We don't really know.
But the checks, according to Yuse Conejos, they did not handle cash. They asked the PCSO to deliver these checks personally to the victims' beneficiaries in a check form. The amounts are there. The money did not go through the DFA.
So we really cannot comment because we were not there when this happened.
And we do not even know if the blood money came from the intelligence fund. because it was just reported, actually it was the first time that we heard it from the former GM, that part of the intelligence fund was used for blood money. Mm-hmm. But as far as we are concerned, we are not even sure if indeed it was charged to the intelligence fund, because the checks that we saw were issued in her name. So we do not know if those
the checks that you saw were issued
in the name of the former general manager,
GM Uriarte.
Yes.
And then were subsequent checks.
Yeah, checks. So we do not know also if the checks that were turned over to the families are her personal checks or checks of PCSO.
Or the bank manager.
Or a manager check.
That's money trail that can easily be checked.
Yes.
Money trail that can easily be checked.
We can check the withdrawals.
Yes.
Whether it was given to the family, that we do not know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because as she claims, it was withdrawn as cash and given to the Cornejo.
Okay, so we're talking of Intel funds, and that is going to be the subject of an executive session where she supposedly will disclose mainly to the senators on how the money was used. So does that mean it's the end of your audit trail? Do you still can find out as PCSO board now as to what she will be disclosing to the senators? Will that form part of the report of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee to the present board? What do you think?
We're not sure, but whatever it may be, we are more than happy to give whatever that we can in order for this investigation to have a closure and for the proper agencies to do whatever that they should do.
Mm-hmm. So, in the present board's vision, mission, objectives, are you now saying that there should be no bishop, no other man of man representing a religious organization or denomination can request for an ambulance?
Oh, no.
No.
Definitely they can.
Yes.
In fact, Director Mamba.
In fact, during
the
present board.
The bishops can continue.
Yes, in fact.
Asking for an ambulance.
Yes, in fact, the present board has already turned over some ambulances to parish pastoral councils, because
how many ambulances have
I
you turned
think
over?
We've turned over four, and then one to a foundation run by a Protestant church.
Okay, have you turned over under the present board to politicians, congressmen, mayor, barangay, senators?
I think we should also describe it as turning it over to them for the service of the community.
Yes.
So it's not really turning it over to the politician. We seek the politician's assistance, actually, to confirm if indeed an area would be in need of an ambulance. Because as far as the present board is concerned, we do not only depend on the requests that we receive, but we also do a poverty mapping as well as a needs mapping.
Yeah.
So we check which areas have not received an ambulance for the past 5 years.
Okay, if there were politicians who were given, based on your mapping, on the needs assessment, and all of the requirements, did you give any politician under your watch an ambulance or a regional health office facility support or medicine support?
Yes, we gave, because when we arrived...
From the entire political spectrum, those who are opposition and those who are, okay?
Yes.
Those in the opposition, who did you give to?
We don't really remember the names, but more of the areas. So,
municipalities.
No. This is how it is now.
Well,
being
presented
because in the first place there were names that came out and bishops were named.
Yes.
Okay. And there is a call by the old board. Why don't you also disclose who are the people, who are the bishops you have given these ambulances to? Who were the politicians, whether they are from both sides of the pendulum, political pendulum? Is that not being transparent in the way you do your job now?
No, actually, we're very transparent. Our list is open.
Mm-hmm.
You can find the list there of the different municipalities, rural health units, hospitals that have received ambulances.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are some areas there that have endorsements from a congressman or from a senator.
You do not put a value to that.
Yes. It's more of, even if we receive a request from a particular senator that I may be close to or we may be close to, we still check if indeed they have received any. And I think you can check if a person is really ready for a responsible position, if they can say no. So I think there's a proper way of saying no, or telling them that maybe if we cannot include in this batch,
this
maybe
online,
the next
this is
one.
Online. This is online allocation of ambulances, of medicines, of regional hospital facilities that is online, and
yes,
the districts.
Request.
So
yes,
there
yes.
is no reference to who actually presented it to you.
Yes, but if somebody would be interested to find out, then it's all in our files of who are the people who endorsed an ambulance for any particular locality.
Actually, Tina.
And does it show in the vehicle this was
no,
a project
that's,
of
yeah, those are one of the
congressman
things.
Congressman.
Yeah, those are one of the things that we remind and
there's no more
and
picture.
Discourage, yes.
No, that's okay. part
not
of the MOA.
Yes. Not to put any additional decals, yes.
Okay, well, one quick thing before I read the
yes,
comments. Yes,
because the thing is, it was made a policy by the new board that the request for the ambulances would be based more on the area. The endorsers would just be secondary. And at the same time, they came up with a new policy wherein 4th, 5th, and 6th class municipalities, as long as they are attached to a health center or a hospital, their ambulance would be 100% for free.
For free. But if not, then it's 60-40.
It's first, second, or third class municipality. There's a counterpart of 40%.
Yes. Okay, let me just read the comments, lady and gentlemen. A viewer says, do an audit. Put someone who can handle the accounting of PCSO funds. Dapat malinaw ang guidelines. Donations should be clearly defined and followed para pag may anomaly, alam sino ang hinahabol. From PAC, they should have a website that tells all their activities and donations. You have?
Yes,
and donations should not be through politicians. It should be straight to the beneficiaries. Are you doing that?
Yeah, that's why for the ambulances, what appears in our list are the municipalities. And also in the MOA, if we find out that an ambulance was misused or is being used for personal needs of whomever, then we give them a warning. And if they still proceed in using it improperly, then we can even take it back.
Okay. We'll pause for a break. But if you're interested to really find out the details of how they do their assistance programs, there is one for purchase of medicines. There is one for ambulance donation. And they have requirements for hospital medical facility, what the papers you need to submit. Requirements for non-government organization, government organization, private organization, etc. So it's all there, and many other FAQs, frequently asked questions. You can join this discussion, our question of the day, what should the PCSO do to make its donations transparent? Text us, react, space, ANC space with your name, address, and message. Then send to 2331 for Globe. Touch Mobile, Bayan, and Sun subscribers, and 231 for Smart and Talk and Text subscribers. And send us your tweets at twitter.com/ANC Alerts and be a fan of Talkback with Tina Palma on Facebook. Stay with us, please.